Welcome to worship at our Saviour's as we continue to celebrate the season of Easter. We invite you to speak the words of our call to worship with us. As Jesus appeared among his disciples, saying, "Peace be with you," so may peace fill our hearts and this place today.
May the peace of Christ dwell richly within us, binding us together in love and unity.
Christ invites us to behold his wounds and to believe. He invites us to witness the reality of his resurrection.
With awe and wonder, we are ready to embrace the transformative power of Jesus' victory over death.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Is alive, let Christians sing. The cross stands empty to the sky. Let streets and homes with praises ring. Love drowned in death shall never die. Christ is alive, no longer bound to distant. Saving, healing here and now, and touching every place and time. In every insult, rift, and war, where color scorn or wealth divide, Christ suffers still, yet loves the more, and lives where even hope has died. Women and men in age and youth can feel the Spirit, hear the call, and find the way.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you. Welcome again to worship at our Saviour's. Wow, did you see the eclipse last week? I happened to notice that when I was looking at it, that I began to see the logo for our Thrive capital campaign glowing within the sun. How cool is that? I think that's perhaps because with just a few more commitments, we will be able to eclipse our next goal, to not only help us renovate our church building, but also to help us update our live streaming capabilities. So far, 303 households have made a commitment to the Thrive campaign. If you have not yet made a commitment or given a gift, now is the time. You'll find information about the campaign on our website. You can give a one-time gift, or you can schedule ongoing gifts. Also, while on our website, you can register your child or grandchild for Vacation Bible School. It is coming up at the end of June. And you can learn about our Holy Socks and Holy Shoes recycling event happening at our Saviour's right now. If you have old socks or old shoes, don't just throw them in the trash. Bring them to church to be recycled. And speaking of recycling, we're also recycling these eclipse glasses. There's another eclipse happening in South America in October, so we're collecting them to be redistributed. Just bring your glasses to church, where you'll find a collection box in the same place that all of our other recycling items are collected. Welcome again to worship. We continue now with our Bible readings.
A reading from 1 John chapter 3. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, you are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. Everyone who commits sin is guilty of lawlessness. Sin is lawlessness. You know that he was revealed to take away sins, and in him there is no sin. No one who abides in him sins. No one who sins has either seen him or known him. Little children, let no one deceive you. Everyone who does what is right is righteous, just as he is righteous. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God. Gospel according to Luke, the 24th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus himself stood among the disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you." They were startled and terrified and thought that they were seeing a ghost. He said to them, "Why are you frightened? And why do doubts arise in your hearts? Look at my hands and my feet. See that it is I myself. Touch me and see. For a ghost does not have flesh and bones as you see that I have." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. While in their joy they were disbelieving and still wondering, he said to them, "Have you anything here to eat?" They gave him a piece of boiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence. Then he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our strength, our Redeemer. Amen. There are a lot of moments in my life where I can really say, "I can't believe it. I can't believe he did it," or "I can't believe that happened." Lots of moments. The very first time my sons flipped off of the high diving board at the swimming pool, they went up the ladder, and although I knew it to be true, I knew they could swim, I knew that they would take risk, I didn't believe that they would jump off the diving board. There they were. And as he flipped over into the water, first son, and then flipped over again, second son, I sat on the dock, sat on the edge of the pool, cheering, excited, and I walked away and going, "I can't believe they did it. They actually did it." It was the same thing when I learned how to ride a motorcycle. The very first day that I took off out of my driveway, having not sat on my motorcycle yet for the first time, had taken the classes. I had been certified. I had passed all the requisite tests. And then I pulled out of the driveway and drove one block. Came back around and pulled in my driveway. And after I got off my bike, I was like, I can't believe I did it. I really can't believe I did it. Those moments have led into today. My boys still swim. I still ride my motorcycle. And there have been plenty other countless moments. Basketball teams going perfect seasons. Elections that you thought wouldn't happen. People getting voted on or off the island. Stars being selected to be the best dancer or the best singer or whoever has the most talent. You always wonder, in disbelief sometimes, how certain people get what they get. One of the most recent, I can't believe it, is when the lotto started to hit the billion marker and somebody, one ticket would win and you'd stand there going, I can't believe it. That's a lot of money. I can't believe one person, one ticket. They didn't buy hundreds of tickets. They only bought one and they win. It's unbelievable even if you're happy for someone. It's unbelievable even if you're joyful. We have lots of moments in our lives like that, whether it's births of children, marriages, promotions, whether it's grandiose vacations, or something simple. You watch an aunt carry an entire potato chip across the floor. I can't believe they did it. Today's gospel story is one of such occasions. The disciples are now in another day, another week of the resurrection having happened already. They've already met with Thomas, who they called the doubter. They've already seen Jesus. They've already looked at the tomb, no doubt, and seen the grave clothes. And all of them are probably going, I can't believe that happened. And now here they are in a room again, after this first moment with Jesus, waiting. Jesus appears, and among the joy of going, did last week really happen? Jesus shows up, and they are in shock. They are in disbelief. They are in joy-filled terror. This is not happening. Pinch me. I am not awake right now. I can imagine the disciples going, I can't believe it. I can't believe you're really here. Like, there's no way. We saw you get crucified. There is no way. And I know we saw you last week, but clearly I was dreaming. Clearly I was in some kind of fog or haze that wasn't the real Jesus. It was just me hoping that you were alive. And now they're in a room, and there Jesus is. So much so that Jesus almost has to perform a magic trick, if you will. Jesus asks them for a piece of bread, and says, do you have any bread with you? And he eats it so that they know that he's ingesting real food. They know that he is actually chewing and his body is working the way human bodies would respond when digesting food. And even still, they are in joy-filled terror. Here's the thing, people of God. Life didn't stop just because we celebrated Resurrection Sunday just a little over a week ago. Life didn't stop. Relationships kept happening. Children were still being born. Jobs were happening. Promotions were happening. Firings were happening. Diagnoses of illness or cures were still happening, even in the midst of the resurrection. And while it seems like it was so long ago, it really wasn't that far away. It's not that far in our past. Easter has indeed happened. The resurrection is here. And the good news is that the resurrection is for all time. Jesus beat death, and it wasn't a moment that we have to wait for next year. It has happened, and it continues to happen in our lives. God's signs of life continue to happen in our lives, even when we just don't believe it. Even when we think it can't be real, even when we think we're in a haze or a fog, good or bad, indifferent or otherwise, the resurrection continues. God's promise, God's gift, God's covenant of eternal life, beginning with Jesus, lives on through us. And the gospel ends it in this way. you are witnesses. We are the resurrection testimony. Not just one Sunday, but all throughout our lives. Not just a week ago when the lilies have gone home and when the Easter finery has put away and the clouds have rolled back in and there's no sun. The resurrection, the Easter story, the Jesus is alive, Christ is risen, he is risen indeed, hallelujah, walks into us, continues with us, and walks out of our places of worship, out of our homes. It walks out into the world, even when we're walking around going, I can't believe it. Believe it, ladies and gentlemen. Believe it, sisters and brothers in Christ. Believe it, beloved children of God. The resurrection continues. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, the kindness of a Saviour, the hope of nations. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. As you find me, all my fears and failures, build my life again. I give my life to follow everything I believe in. Now I surrender. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. So I say, shine your light out, let the whole world sing. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world sing. We're singing for the glory of the risen King.
Let us declare our faith together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Rejoicing that Jesus is risen and love has triumphed over fear, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need of good news. O God, our Holy One, you feed our deepest hungers. As we share in the holy meal that is the body and blood of Jesus given for us, lead us to share all that we have and find in generosity. We lift in prayer those in our community, nation, and world who are hungry. We pray for you to give the hungry daily bread today and to provide the food that children need to grow and thrive. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, our Creator, you bring forth all life on earth. Restore balance to the earth's fragile habitats. Preserve wilderness lands, rainforests, and wildlife. Calm storms, bring water to parched places, and protect the climate so that this planet would sustain life in all its varieties. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, our Savior, you offer wisdom and guidance beyond all human knowledge. Instruct lawmakers, judges, and elected officials to make decisions grounded in your justice and care for all people. Bring hope to any who feel forsaken or forgotten. We pray for any who are incarcerated, institutionalized, or in foster care, that they may know your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, our center, you care for all your children. Encourage those who are in times of transition, facing the loss of old ways and routines, and anticipating change. Relieve all who live with chronic illness and pain. We pray for those who need your healing touch. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. O God, our resting place, your Son Jesus promised that we are held in your love forever. We remember our beloved who have died. Encourage us with the promise that all who call upon your name will be saved. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your hands, most merciful God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your abiding love, through Jesus Christ, our resurrected and living Lord. Amen.
And now this blessing from God. May the Lord bless and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you with grace and mercy. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.